Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, we have a handful of standard SpaceX bits to take a look at with another amazing launch. Then we have a bunch of bits in Boca Chica with infrastructure and Starship and a look at SN9 after its fall. Let's head straight in and get up to date. First up, on Sunday, SpaceX launched the SXM-7 satellite on a Falcon 9 rocket.
Zero, ignition, and we have liftoff.
The booster, B-1051, which was flying for the seventh time, then became the second booster to land for the seventh time.
...of this particular booster, also marking the 69th successful recovery of a Falcon 9 first stage.
On the SpaceX fans website, you can see that we have another and the final SpaceX launch of 2020 tomorrow. NROL 108 is expected to lift off at 2 p.m. UTC or 9 a.m. EDT. SpaceX's third operational Crew Dragon mission to the ISS is expected in fall of 2021, and NASA have released an article about the crew. It says that NASA and ESA have selected three astronauts to serve as crew members for the mission. There's an interesting tweet from Michael Sheets with SpaceX expected to increase their West Coast operations. He said, SpaceX manager of Falcon 9 operations Stephen Cameron says the West Coast launch and landing site is expanding significantly. The company is looking to hire significantly at Vandenberg Air Force Base in California, including a launch site mission manager. There's a new article posted by Business Insider with SpaceX apparently looking to double its valuation to $92 billion. That's it for the standard updates, but in Boca Chica, the orbital launch pad construction has been continuing. In the launch area, a new rental Manitowoc crane was seen after having been delivered. They were also seen moving pieces as they started putting this huge machine together. Here's a view of the suborbital launch mount at Pad A where SN8 recently lifted off for its 12.5 km flight. Engineers have been working on the mount after the launch to repair it as it took quite a beating from those Raptors. In front of the launch mounts, they've been continuing with the wall and are pretty much done with this section. It looks like there's also been a bunch of deliveries to the tank farm with it seen venting. Over at another part of the facility, work has been continuing with the old gaswell lot area. There are also some deliveries that have been spotted. Here we have what looks to be part of a transport mount. Also seen are these things, which are apparently power units for the transporters SpaceX rents. Looking at Starship pieces now, a stack was seen moved outside with this common dome section. I want to share this great view of the sleeving area of the yard behind the tents where SpaceX have a whole load of domes of different types sitting around. Just a bit to the right of this is the nose cone area where there's currently some barrel sections and a tapered nose cone piece sitting outside. Moving on to a bit of SN8 after it crashed landed but performing a spectacularly successful test. Engineers are working to clean up the landing pad area with some pieces gone but some more to go. Elon Musk mentioned preserving the SN8 nose cone, which you can see here with other pieces that should be scrapped. SN9 recently had a little trip and the high bay managed to catch it. Tankzilla was hooked up to the prototype to get it upright again. Here's a view of one of the fins with quite a bit of damage where it was crushed against the high bay wall. Looks like there's a little bit of a dent to the nose cone too. The area outside the high bay was cleared in order for SN9 to be moved by the crane. SN9 was then lifted off its stand and moved outside the high bay where you can see that fin better. After a little bit, the prototype was moved back into the high bay and placed on a new transport mount. There was a new flap that was also spotted, possibly the replacement for SN9. We have some great news with this Starship though, as new road closures were added to the Cameron County website. So we might see Rollout tomorrow as a primary closure and Friday as a backup. I can't wait to see SN9 roll out and fly. Last episode we saw the nose cone, which has aero surface covers installed for the fins and is likely for SN10. It has since been moved into the windbreaker structure for stacking and canard installation. Also, its corresponding barrel section was seen with lead-ins installed waiting to be stacked. One of the canards was also seen being lifted in order for it to be installed onto the nose. Another piece of a Starship was spotted with this tapered nose cone piece. It has a label saying it's for SN14. It goes without saying, but without Mary or Boca Chica Girl going out and filming this awesome footage, we wouldn't have these detailed updates, so thanks to her. Also working behind the scenes is the NASA spaceflight team, always providing awesome space coverage and live streams, so thanks to all of them too. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.